Directo a la Comunidad on BCTV is supported by UPMC for you.
Good evening, buenas noches. It's Wednesday, November 14th. It's miércoles, noviembre 14, 2018, 2018. This is my program, Directo a la Comunidad, Direct to the Community. It's BCTV, Channel 15, or www.bctv.org. It's from 6:37 every second Wednesday of the month. Segundo miércoles del mes, aquí en BCTV, los canales 15 o bctv.org. Lo puedes ver en su computadora. De 6 y media a 7, se pueden comunicar conmigo al 610-378-0426 para llamar en vivo. If you'd like to call us during the program live, the number is 610-378-0426. My program today is going to be in Spanish and English because I think that everybody in the city should be aware, especially during Thanksgiving and Christmas. You should be aware of it all the time, but especially during Christmas, Thanksgiving, the holidays, New Year's Eve, the DUIs, what consists of DUI. And with me, I have a Central Regional DUI Enforcement Program, and I've had them with me several times. It's a pleasure to have him with me. Good evening.
Thank you, Hector.
How are you, Dave?
Fine, thank you.
Why don't we let the community know your name and what your job is?
My name's David Everly. I'm the regional coordinator for the North Central Regional DUI Enforcement Program. We coordinate the municipal police DUI enforcement, which will be the checkpoints, roving patrols in 10 counties, including Berks.
Dave trabaja con, como dice, Central Regional DUI Enforcement Program, un programa que van a diferentes ciudades, diferentes condados en el estado de Pensilvania. El trabajo de ellos es preparar, enforzar y tener checkpoints, puntos donde si tú sales de un club o tú estás afuera un sábado, viernes, sábado, domingo, hasta jueves, ellos preparan una calle principal como la 5, la 61, la 183, la 422 y preparan a una cierta hora y si tú estás tomando y tú pasas por ahí, te buscas un lío bien grande. What is a DUI?
A DUI, that's a little bit of a complex answer to that.
Sure.
For an adult 21 years old or older, for alcohol, in Pennsylvania, and as many other states, they have what's called a per se law.
Right.
A per se law is that if you are at a certain level, you're automatically presumed to be impaired and you don't have an argument against it. Pennsylvania and all the other states is a
0.08.
If you're under 21, it's a 0.02.
0.02 for under 21.
Yes. Less than 21, it's a 0.02. And that'll be your DUI offense.
Okay.
Same as an adult. If you're driving a commercial vehicle, then you're limited to a 0.04 would be your criminal offense. However, any amount of alcohol in you would be a summary offense, which you would get a fine.
Sure.
And then also sanction under the federal DOT because you have a commercial license.
Mm-hmm.
And then for school bus operators, school vehicles included, that's a 0.02 also. So that's, you know, very, and any alcohol in their system is a violation also.
So le pregunté al caballero que es un DUI. El DUI es una persona que tenga 21 años o más y tiene la sangre a un .08 en el estado de Pensilvania, legalmente está intoxicado. Si eres una persona menos de 21 años, estás tomando ilegal en Pensilvania y es un .02. Y para chofer de troz es un .04 y para choferes de guagua de la escuela es un .02. Quiere decir que cualquiera de estos se consigue usted en un dilema bastante, bastante mal.
Now, when you're looking at impaired driving, it's not just alcohol, it's also drugs, right, and controlled substances.
And I wanted to hit that because that's one of my questions. One of the questions was, you got a DUI, but DUI nowadays consists, at one point back in the 70s, 80s, DUI was alcohol.
Yes.
But we have a problem with marijuana, cocaine, methamphetamine,
heroin,
illegal drugs, heroin,
opioids, yes.
Even
methadone. People go get methadone,
sure,
they're driving impaired.
Sure. Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about that. Let's
okay.
talk about...
And in fact, it's considerably high. It's not unusual for us to have more drug-impaired people that we arrest than alcohol.
So in a DUI stop, you could have more people under the influence of prescription drugs or illegal
yes.
drugs?
For example, I guess it was like 2 weeks ago tonight, I believe it was October 31st, Halloween.
Halloween.
We did a checkpoint in Muhlenberg Township on the 5th Street Highway.
Yeah.
And that was Halloween night, a Wednesday night.
Wednesday
we night. Had eight DUIs Six of them were drug, one was alcohol alone, and then the other one was a combination of drugs and alcohol, and that's a Wednesday night.
Ellos prepararon un stop, prepararon un DUI stop en Muhlenberg Township, las 5, el día 31 de octubre, que fue la noche de Halloween. En ese punto cogieron un montón de personas, y eso era un miércoles, creo que eran dos personas con alcohol. 8 personas tenían drogas ilegales o legal, y otra vez, esto es una situación bastante mal. Let's talk about, we talked about alcohol, being impaired with alcohol, and I think a lot of people know that. My concern is a lot of people take prescription drugs, painkillers, and a lot of people think that because the doctor gave you the painkillers, it's okay for you to drive, and you know I was guilty of that. For 19 years, you know, I was on heavy painkillers that I took a lot, but you drive with them, and you shouldn't be driving with these pills. You should be. So the laws are really strict with that, too.
Yes. And you should, any medication that you have, you should check with your pharmacist and your doctor, and you should also check, because some medicines by themselves might be okay, but then if you might have an effect if you take another type of medicine with it, or alcohol. Sometimes they'll say, do not drink using this medication.
Right. Machine
There's
or
probably
alcohol.
Could be a reason that could enhance
and
multiply the effects of the drug that you've got a prescription for. So you always want to check with your pharmacist and your doctor. And if it does say on there, do not operate machinery or drive a vehicle, that's should be an indication to you there that, and you don't want to get in a crash and hurt and kill somebody.
No. Hay muchas personas que toman sus pastillas. Yo era una persona culpable de eso. Por varios años estuve tomando las pastillas de dolor. Y pues te toma la pastilla de dolor y sale, y la ley es estricta y también la ley en fuerza, que si tú estás tomando las pastillas de dolor o estás tomando pastillas ilegales o estás tomando, estás cogiendo drogas ilegales, te van a coger también, porque aquí en Estado de Pensilvania eso es ilegal y estás tomando debajo de la influencia.
Now, when you're talking illegal substances like marijuana, cocaine, opioids, any Schedule I controlled substance, which there's no medical benefit for it, so you can't have a prescription for it. Or anybody that has a Schedule 2 or 3 controlled substance in their system that doesn't have a prescription for it, you don't need to show a metabolite, just any amount is driving under drug impairment.
Muchas personas, como dice Dave, muchas personas cogen pastillas de otras personas y se las toman. Dice Dave que cualquier persona que está tomando pastillas de dolor, pastillas con narcóticos, usted va a ser arrestado si no está a nombre tuyo y tú te lo estás tomando, automáticamente estás causando un crimen. Aquí en Estado de Pensilvania, si tú tienes las pastillas y están a nombre de otra persona, muchas personas pues toman dos pastillitas que te van a ayudar. Eso es ilegal y si te cogen tomando con eso, automáticamente es una ofensa criminal.
As far as marijuana goes, in Pennsylvania, it's Commonwealth versus Jones. It's a Pennsylvania Supreme Court decision from 2015, and the Supreme Court in Pennsylvania ruled there was a motorist stopped. The only person in the vehicle, there was an odor of marijuana. They ruled that you don't need any other probable cause. It's just that odor, and the only person in it, the officer can request a person take a blood test. Right. Any marijuana is detected, that's the misdemeanor DUI.
Let me ask you a question, Dave. You're at a stop. You've done these many times, and somebody comes in. How does a police officer tell that somebody's under? I mean, some people are bloodshot, but I'm remembering the time.
Marijuana is the odor.
Yeah, the odor and the bloodshot eyes. But painkillers, I guess, by their action, they.
Well, there's a program called A-Ride, and we just did a clash yesterday, which we had some municipal police and state police from Troop L, Reading, and Jonestown, Hamburg, Barracks, Schoolhaven.
Yes.
And that is Advanced Roadside Impaired Driving Enforcement, and that teaches police officers. Now, you're not a drug expert, but it gives you an idea. Looking at somebody's pupils, you could just be, while they're sitting in a car with a conversation, if it's normally the checkpoints are at night. If it's dark out and you look at somebody and their eye pupils are like pinpricks, you know that there's something that they're on a narcotic, because you would have at that time of night your eyes would be dilated, right, not constricted.
I would believe also that if a police officer shined the light,
well, you're not really. Yeah, they would get short, but you're not shining it in people's eyes. But there's enough of light at the scene that you can look at somebody's pupils and they're like a pin.
Right.
There's something there.
So pues esas personas que se creen que van a ir a un stop sign y no van a un DUI check y no van a chequear. La policía lo están entrenando para ver a esas personas que están debajo de la influencia de droga, legal o no legal. So, es bien importante que ustedes, y la razón que estoy haciendo este programa hoy, es porque están llegando Acción de Gracia, Thanksgiving, está llegando las Navidades, está llegando Año Nuevo. Y muchos de nosotros nos gusta tomar su traguito. Hay personas allá que usan las drogas. Y ahora hay personas cogiendo la marihuana porque los doctores la están dando. Tú lo estás haciendo, pero tú te estás riegando montándote en el carro. I'm just saying, you know, the state of Pennsylvania, okay, Dave, marijuana is now legal for medical use.
Yes, not smokable.
Not smoke, yeah. Right. But a lot of people don't realize that if you use it and you go
there's
still a DUI.
Yes, and marijuana, regardless of what the states say, under federal law, it's still a Schedule 1 controlled substance.
So, déjenme informar lo que me dijo el caballero. Mucha gente tiene que pensar que la marihuana es legal en el estado, pero no es legal con el gobierno federal. So, tú puedes coger cargos federales y no del estado. Algo que deben de pensar. Dave, let's talk about 1, 2, and 3 times being caught with DUI. Your first offense. What's going to happen to your first offense?
Well, first offense, depending on if you're a very high level, then you're not eligible for ARD. If you're in a motor vehicle crash, you're not eligible for ARD.
No ARD with a crash.
It's up to the district attorney. If you don't have a previous criminal record, it's your first offense. You can get ARD, which is accelerated rehabilitative disposition, which would be you would get a suspension and you have to go for alcohol safe driving courses and be on probation for a period of time. Right. And you would have a license suspension. Either if you're not on that, then and it depends on what your BAC is and that, but now the law had changed that everybody is going to have to have an interlock license before you can be eligible to get your license back. And when you do, you'll have an interlock.
And to
start the vehicle, and then I think it's at random, somewhere like between up to 45 minutes after you're operating it, you'll get an alert, and it gives you so many minutes to safely pull over, and then you got to give another breath sample.
Si a ti te cogen, yo le pregunté sobre la primera, la segunda, la tercera vez. Hay personas que han acogido mucho, pero la primera vez si cualificar es que nunca ha tenido un récord, que está en un nivel como un .08 al .10, te van a dar un ARD, que tienes la oportunidad de borrar, pero vas a tener que coger curso y te va a costar como $5,000 por la primera vez. Más te van a suspender la licencia suspensions for first time, what, 30 to 90 days?
I'd have to, it's complicated.
Yeah, it is.
I would have to have the vehicle code with me to look that up.
Yo diría como de 30 a 90 días la primera vez que te cojan, dependiendo, porque si en el punto que tú estás tomando y tú tienes un accidente con otro carro, pues entonces todo cambia, no vas a cualificar para ARD. So what I said was, if you have a car accident, your ARD is out the door.
Right, yeah. Yes.
So let's go to your
now,
second time.
Now, as far as, yes, well, the second time the penalty is enhanced.
Right.
However, there is a proposed change in the law, which is Senate Bill 691. I'm not sure exactly how far along that is to being enacted.
Okay.
However, that would make, and the penalties would increase, but up to, once you get to the fourth offense for DUI, it doesn't have to be a crash, just the regular your DUI, it'd be a felony three.
So, hay personas que tienen 1, 2, 3. Si llegas ahora a 4, está cambiando. La ley se llama 691. Ha sido introducido al gobierno del estado. Y si la pasan, se va a hacer mucho más fuerte. Si te cogen tomando las multas, todo se va a complicar doble y triple.
And that bill also would have enhanced penalties if you're operating without a valid license, whether or not it's suspended, revoked, or you just don't have one. Right. That would make it severely increase penalties up to, depending on the offense that was accompanying it, felonies.
Wow.
So if you're not a licensed driver, you'd make sure you're not driving impaired.
Déjame explicar que es un misdemeanor en el estado de Pennsylvania, pero acaban de decir que si te cogen la cuarta vez, se hace un felony, que es un caso bastante fuerte. We were talking the second time. Did we talk about the second time?
We did, and with the sentencing, I do have that. I'd have
that's
to read through it.
It's complicated.
It's complicated.
Are you guys planning?
There's sentencing guidelines at that court that the, right. the court figures out and so forth for different factors, but it's good, the penalty will increase.
I have a question.
Your license suspension will greatly increase.
Greatly increase.
And so you would be, you could be, once you get your habitual offender, which you could be on, get sentenced up to 5 years or be on probation, you at least for 5 years. So.
You know, something happened to me about 3 or 4 weeks ago. I was at the gym working, and a gentleman came in to sign up for the gym. I refused to sign him up because he was so drunk. Mm. You can smell it. Mm-hmm. And I want you to, I did something, I just want to know. So when he left the gym, I told my coordinator, and after he told me a couple of nice words, I told him, come back when you're not, because he was drunk. And the smell of vodka got in his truck and took off. And I felt responsible to call 911, let them know that this mm-hmm. gentleman was on a truck. It's a 5,000 pound truck.
Oh, yeah.
And he was driving. He couldn't even walk in the gym. I got a letter from the courts. They caught him.
Really?
Yeah,
good.
They caught him on Fifth Street Highway, and I'm supposed to
now go. Now you're going to be a witness.
Yeah. I mean, and really, I mean, yeah. I think the reason I'm saying is that I think that people should be responsible.
Yes.
So when you see somebody driving under the influence, or you talk to somebody who's not in the car yet, and he goes and you got to remember, it's not your family, but he could kill somebody.
That's correct.
He could kill himself or kill somebody, innocent people. Mm-hmm. And I think it's the responsibility of somebody. My feeling is that if you're at a party, that if you're at a gathering, you see somebody drinking. Listen, I'm not telling you to be rude, but just go up and take the keys. Volunteer to take them home.
Yes.
Because I don't know if the laws, is there a law in Pennsylvania that if you have somebody at your house and they're drinking and pounding them down, they go out and let's say they kill somebody. Can
they,
that come
they
back
They call
to
it the dram shop laws and all. I'm not 100% sure with all the case law on that, but I'm sure you could be civilly sued.
Yeah.
If you're the host and you're supplying the alcohol.
You're going to be a serious
trouble. Yeah.
Estaba hablando con Dave de una situación que si tú tienes una fiesta, tú tienes una actividad en tu hogar o están teniendo un party en un sitio que han rentado, si le están sirviendo alcohol a una persona y una persona sale y tú tienes esa responsabilidad de tu fiesta, te pueden venir para atrás y meterte una demanda si esa persona mata o se golpea. Bien importante que aprendan las leyes y eso es bien fácil a la computadora. Is there a website where people can go to see these things, the laws and...
Well, offhand, they could Google. You could do Pennsylvania DUI Association, and you could just Pennsylvania DUI laws. And most of the times, the first couple hits that come back are going to be for defense attorneys.
Yeah.
And a lot of those will have explanations in there as to what the laws and penalties are before they tell you to call them right. if you got a DUI and.
There's other laws, too, that if you're in the car and you have your child, I remember
yes.
last time we met.
Yes, and that's in the Senate bill, too, to get changed.
That's going to even get worse.
If it gets, yes. Right now, if there's a minor in your vehicle, which is somebody under 18, and this also pertains to people under 21 driving. So mm-hmm. if you're a teenager and you got some of your friends in your car and you're out partying and drinking or smoking drugs or marijuana mm-hmm. or other
sure.
drugs, and there's other people in the vehicle that are under 18, you're subject to being charged
sure.
with this too. But besides your impaired driving offense, it's another first offense for each person under 18
under
in the
18.
Vehicle is another misdemeanor one. And the first offense is a $1,000 fine and 100 hours of community service. Second offense is a misdemeanor one with a $2,500 minimum fine for each person that's under 18, and 1 to 6 months in jail plus
wow.
your community service. Third offense is another misdemeanor, and that's 2 years in jail. For
this
each
is
person.
Children in the car.
Yes, for somebody under 18. And they wanted to, in the Senate Bill 691 would change it that the third and subsequent offenses, instead of being a misdemeanor with 2 years in jail, it would be a felony three, which you get substantially more penalty.
Le hice la pregunta de esas personas que tienen niños en el carro, que sea tu hijo, tu hija, o que sea una amistad. Si tienen menos de 18 años, están en tu carro y te cogen tomando... mira, está manejando, las cosas se complican más, se ponen bien feas. So, recuerden, ahí ahora están bregando con esta ley nueva, 691, que va, uh-huh. van a ser la va a ser más peor de lo que las multas, tiempo en la cárcel. So, es bien importante que se eduquen esas personas que quieren tomar. No estoy diciendo que no tomen, muchas personas les gustan tomar, pero viene responsabilidad con esa tomar.
Okay. And coming up. Next Wednesday night, it's Thanksgiving Eve.
I was just going to ask you about DUI checks because we got a few minutes. I want to know what's, I know you guys are big time.
Well, Thanksgiving Eve is probably the biggest night for impaired driving of the year.
And I want to transition. So Thanksgiving evening, how many roads do you think you guys?
Well, it's hard to say. We do them everywhere, weather permitting, we'll be out. And the reason for that is, I think, is a lot of it is everybody's home, all the college kids are home. Yep. Everybody's home from college. They didn't see their friends since the September, August.
Right.
And then also very few people work Thanksgiving Day. So all the adults are off. They're not working the next day. The only people working are hospital people, firemen, and police.
Yeah. And everybody else is partying.
Yep. And bars are always full. It's like I said, it's one of the biggest nights of the year.
Yeah, there's this big, I don't want to mention, but there's like six clubs in the city that they're going to have them parties. Let me say that.
And last year in Pennsylvania, and it goes every year, that's the most DUI crashes is Thanksgiving Eve and Thanksgiving Day.
Deme recordarle Acción de Gracias la semana que viene. Jueves. Una de las razones que tomé hacer este programa hoy es por eso, por Acción de Gracia, por la Navidad de Año Nuevo. No podemos decir dónde van a estar, pero déjeme asegurarle que la noche de Acción de Gracia, Thanksgiving Night, van a haber un montón de carreteras CTA.
It's bigger New Year's Eve or any other.
We got 3 minutes. Any last words, my friend?
Yes. Drink and drive or do drugs and drive. And when you are in a vehicle, wear your seatbelt. And make sure everybody else is buckled up in the vehicle, too.
If you're hosting
a party, make arrangements for people
with
to
people
stay there.
To stay there or to get somebody to take them, a designated driver. Thank you, Dave.
Thank you for having me.
Antes de irme, quiero dedicar este programa a mi querido amigo, mi hermanito, Georgie Betancourt. Georgie falleció esta mañana. Hoy, mayo, hoy es el día 14. El día 14 de noviembre. Georgie nació mayo 30, 1968. Su padre Manuela Betancourt y su mamá Blanca Rivera y sus hermanos y hermanas le mandan los pésames. El viewing lo van a velar en Henninger's Funeral Home lunes de 6 a 8 en el 229 norte de la calle 5. Le doy la gracia que pasó una acción de gracia especial. Si van a tomar, enganchen la llave o busquen a alguien. Want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving. Please listen to what Dave said, to what we have in this program. Drinking and driving is just, and driving under the influence period, drugs, alcohol. I ask you to have a safe Thanksgiving and Christmas, although I think I'm going to have my program for Christmas, but I want to thank everybody, especially BCTV, for this program. Until I have a program Friday, I hope you can watch me 10:30. And that is with Anne. She's going to talk about Lyme disease, and we're going to do it in Spanish to get that information. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a good night. God bless, and thank you.
Directo a la Comunidad on BCTV is supported by UPMC for you.